Good afternoon and welcome to another episode of Take 10. Today I'm joined with Met Opera trombonist Weston Sprott. In addition to playing second trombone in the Metropolitan Opera, he also teaches at Bard College, Rutgers University. He is the head of brass at Manus, and in addition to that, he travels around the country teaching at various universities like Indiana and also with the New World Symphony. So I know, like I just said a minute ago, you obviously have a lot of things on your plate at one time. Like you're playing in the opera, which is, you know, 5 or 6 nights a week. You're teaching at 3 different universities. You're traveling to teach and play and do all these things. How do you keep that straight when you're going, and how do you keep, you know, everything organized so you're on top of everything whenever you need to be?
Now that it's September, I'm actually at the point where I'm starting to figure all those things out. Actually, usually I figure it out a little bit earlier because, of course, the Met schedule is hectic, the shows are long, and there's lots of services. And the other thing about the Met is that the schedule is very inconsistent. I think in a normal symphony orchestra, you could guarantee for the most part that you have, for example, rehearsal on Tuesday, a double rehearsal on Wednesday, rehearsal on Thursday, and then shows on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or something like that. But the Met does 7 performances a week, Monday through Friday, and then a double on Saturdays right now. And the rehearsal schedule is constantly changing. So 1 week you might play Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, a double on Saturday. And next week you might play Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night, or whatever. There's no 2 weeks that are the same. And then when you're teaching at all these different places and trying to organize all these different trips, whether you're doing guest master class or speaking, it's really just a matter of having a really intense period of scheduling. Every year around the beginning of the season, or a little bit before the beginning of the season or the beginning of the school year, I usually will have tens of hours where I literally sit in front of my computer and just figure out everything. I'm gonna play all of these rehearsals, these shows, and because of the gaps between those, or this night is off, or this morning is free, this is the day where I can teach Manus this week. This is the day where I can teach Bard this week. This is the day where I can teach Rutgers this week. This is the week where I'm going to be teaching Julliard pre-college in the morning. This is where I can fit all these different things in. It's like figuring out a massive puzzle. And of course, with all the teaching, every student has an individual schedule. So it's not only making sure that you have time, but that it fits their time. I would guess that every year is no less than 40 hours of me sitting in front of my computer and just doing scheduling. And for the most part, once that's done, then it kind of just, it's just a matter of me making sure that I show up at all those things. That's where it happens. It's a lot of work up front.
And I'm sure there are a lot of students starting the school year this year where they're being pulled in so many different directions, like, you know, 5 or 6 different classes, 2 or 3 ensembles, you know, whatever else they want to do musically, plus what their teacher wants to do musically. What kind of advice would you give to them to kind of stay on top of everything they need to do while getting all their work done?
I would say you have to prioritize, and you have to plan for your time in the way I just finished talking about planning for your time. You have to make sure that you don't give everything equal weight. You're not going to be able to be great at every single thing. So you have to determine which things you're going to really, really work to excel at and which things you're going to allow yourself to slide on. And that's not to say that you should just forget about a couple of classes and be okay with making an F. But if, for example, you're a trombone performance major, you're going to recognize, hey, my lessons are the most important part of my education and practicing. So what does that mean I have to give up? Maybe that means you have to give up a couple of fun things. Maybe it means you should schedule yourself in a way that allows you to have time to make that a priority. I think a lot of times when students start college, they're very excited about all the opportunities that are available. It's like, yeah, I can play in the orchestra and the wind ensemble and the jazz band and trombone choir and this and that or whatever. And it seems like more and more and more means better, better, better. And one piece of advice I would give people is to start with a little bit less. Try to do enough things, just enough things where you feel like you can be successful. What ends up happening a lot of times is kids try to do everything, and then they find out they're not doing any of those things well. They're falling behind in their lessons. Maybe better off just playing in 1 or 2 ensembles, focusing a lot on your practicing and your lessons, as opposed to trying to put your hand in every pot. And then after you get a little bit more experience, you have the ability to take on more things and actually still manage it.
Now, you just spoke about planning your practicing. Now, how do you go about when you have a week where you're playing 5 nights and you have the Met rehearsals and you have all these lessons and stuff? How do you plan your practice around all those different things so you're staying on top of your own playing?
I have a routine that I do every day. And that routine evolves over the course of the year, over the course of my career. It just depends on what I need. Sometimes I feel like I need more buzzing, sometimes I need more flexibility, whatever it happens to be. But there's always some period of time when that happens. And generally, I try to make sure that that moment happens most of the time within 1 hour of me waking up every single day. I try to get up early enough. And I'm not suggesting I don't get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. That's not my style. But most of my days with a rehearsal will start at 10:30. That's the time I need to be in my chair and I need to be ready to go. If I wake up at 8:30, for example, the horn is usually on my face by 9. And 9 to 10 is dedicated to me warming up and doing different practicing things. I may take a 5-minute break a few times during that period and intermittently answer a couple of emails or drink a cup of coffee, but I'm guaranteed that much time. I happen to have the evening off from a show or I don't have rehearsal that day, that's the additional practice time that's available. I can't say every day I practice 3 hours and always find a way to do that. It evolves depending on the schedule. If the shows are really heavy, you're gonna practice less. You know, if we're playing the Ring Cycle, we're not gonna play Götterdämmerung one night, get up the next day and practice 3 hours individually. You're gonna rest and try to recover, and the shows are gonna be keeping you in shape.